I don't use the word inspiration very often because it always sounded kind of pretentious to me, but I do use the word ideas, which I think is maybe more suitable. I taught painting and drawing at the college level for 36 years and always told my students that the best ideas come out of work, and so that's sort of my philosophy. I think the painter Chuck Close said that that inspiration is for amateurs, the rest of us just show up for work. So just keep working and the ideas come, in other words. And one thing leads to another. Many years ago, I kind of established a vocabulary of subject matter, being primarily vintage clothing, mostly women's clothing. I seldom find men's vintage clothing that I find very interesting. And plant materials, and for some reason those things seem to go together in all sorts of ways that I keep exploring. I'm still enamored with that combination. And found objects from time to time as well. Usually something with a little bit of patina of time on it. So things keep combining and recombining. Sometimes I use the same objects again. It's almost like a repertory company of actors that keep showing up in different plays, playing different roles. But not often do I repeat. I somehow made a transition from painting on canvas about 1971, I guess. So I've been doing this a long time. One thing led again to another of transitioning from a flat picture plane, rectangular, to making a painting any shape I wanted to, and sawing it out of plywood. It started out just as domestic plywood, which is very low quality, lots of cheap filler, and I finally discovered Finnish birch plywood, meaning from Finland, which is has no cheap filler, and every layer is just the same, and works much better. Actually, I started by sawing out a shape of wood with an image on it and putting it on the surface of a canvas, just to add another layer, another degree of interest to the work. And after I did about three or four of those, I said, why do I need the canvas anymore? And again, I can make a painting any shape I want to. So that was my big eureka moment. And things moved on from there, and it got more and more three-dimensional. I got a little more skillful with the craftsmanship, and here I am doing these things. Basically, I spend the first, for a big piece, I would spend maybe the first three or four days just making patterns, just looking at the actual garment or object, whatever it is, and trying to figure out how am I going to build this out of plywood. And they are constructions rather than carving. I never learned to carve, to tell the truth. There is a lot of sanding involved, which is a form of carving, and I know that's a difference that makes no difference to anyone but me, but I've been around real wood carvers, and I would not want to call myself a wood carver, because I know I'm cheating. I'm just trying to build a surface to hang paint on, basically, so I'm not in love with the mystery of wood or the romanticism of wood in that respect. But I do enjoy the building and designing process. There's something about just the problem-solving aspects of it that I enjoy. So I start by making elaborate patterns. I start with a contour line pattern, and then start making tracing paper patterns, analyzing that and the actual garment to figure out how to cut it out and how to join the pieces together. Up folds, down folds, how I'm going to make it layered, and so on. Then comes tracing it onto sheets of plywood of various thicknesses, sawing it out with a scroll saw, and then developing with a belt and disc sander, and finally a little Dremel that has a little sanding drum on it. And then everything is glued together with Elmer's carpenter's glue, and I'm ready to paint after some more sanding. So actually the building takes about half the work, and the painting takes about half the work. And in fact, I tell people that, which is a pretty good description, they're about almost exactly halfway between painting and sculpture. So I was trained as a painter and kind of stumbled into the sculpture through the back door, but that's what it amounts to. Perhaps because I was trained as a painter, I'd still think of maybe a bit more as paintings than as sculptures, but it's really about half and half. They're painted with acrylics, which has been my medium since about 1967. Well, I'm 73 years old now, and basically I just want to keep working as long as I'm physically and mentally able to. And I'm happy to say that I can hardly wait to see what I do next, which is as I said, I've pretty much established my basic vocabulary, and I want to just keep going. I ask people every now and then if they've ever heard of a retired artist, and nobody ever has. I don't get to retire and don't want to, and you just keep going. So it's more of the same, getting better, I hope, following the work where it leads. It is visually, it's visually and mentally accessible. You know, they can recognize these elements easily and make their own personal connections with them. They're things we all remember and have had experiences with. One reason I use clothing is because it has a strong anthropomorphic human presence to it. You know, we identify, we see ourselves in these as images. You know, the clothing is a human presence. The glove is essentially a human hand, for example. And we identify with images of human beings. Perhaps just as much, or in some respects, maybe even more so, because there isn't a specific face or a particular person involved. I think it's that anthropomorphic presence that's, and the clothing pieces for certain, that people connect.